Buju Banton is a Jamaican dancehall and reggae musician. He is widely considered one of the most significant and well-regarded artists in Jamaican music. Banton has collaborated with many international artists, including those in the hip-hop, Latin and punk rock genres, as well as the sons of Bob Marley. Born July 15, 1973. Buju Banton was born in Kingston, Jamaica in a poor neighborhood known as Salt Lane. Buju is a nickname given to him by his mother as a child. Banton is a Jamaican word that refers to someone who is a respected storyteller, and it was adapted by Mairi in tribute to the DJ Buru Banton, whom Buju admired as a child. Buju emulated Buru's rough vocals and forceful delivery, developing his own distinctive style. Buju's mother was a higgler or street vendor, while his father worked as a laborer at a tile factory. He was the youngest of 15 children born into a family that was directly descended from the Maroons of Jamaica. Banton has homes in Jamaica and Tamarack, Florida, United States. He also has 15 children. As a youngster, Buju would often watch his favorite artists perform at outdoor shows and local dancers in Denham Town. At the age of 12, he picked up the microphone for himself and began toasting under the moniker of Gargamel, working with the Sweet Love and Rambo Mango sound systems. In 1986, he was introduced to producer Robert Friends by fellow DJ Clement Irie, and his first single, The Ruler, was released not long afterward in 1987. In 1991, Buju joined Donovan Jermaine's Penthouse Records label and began a fruitful partnership with producer Dave Kelly, who later launched his own Madhouse Records label. Buju is one of the most popular musicians in Jamaican history, having major chart success in 1992, with Bogle and Love Me Browning both massive hits in Jamaica. Controversy erupted over Love Me Browning, which spoke of Banton's penchant for brown-skinned women. Me love my car, me love my bike, me love my money and thing, but most of all me love my browning. Some accused Banton of denigrating the beauty of darker-skinned black women. Banton released a number of dancehall singles as early as 1987 but came to prominence in 1992 with two albums, Stamina Daddy and Mr. Mention the latter, which became the best-selling album in Jamaican history upon its release. That year he also broke the record for own singles in Jamaica, previous held by Bob Marley. He signed with the major label Mercury Records and released Voice of Jamaica in 1993. By the mid-1990s, Banton's music became more influenced by his Rastafari faith, as heard on the seminal albums Till Shiloh and Inner Heights. Till Shiloh successfully blended conscious lyrics with a hard-hitting dancehall vibe. The album included earlier singles such as Murderer, along with instant classics like Wanna Be Loved and Untold Stories. Untold Stories revealed an entirely different side of Buju Banton from the one that had stormed to dancehall stardom. His 2010 album Before the Dawn on Best Reggae Album at the 53rd Annual Grammy Awards. In 2011, he was convicted on the same criminal charge and was imprisoned in the US until December 2018. Whereupon he returned home to Jamaica. Now on the major Mercury or Polygram Records label, Banton released the hard-hitting Voice of Jamaica in 1993. Banton was invited to meet Jamaican Prime Minister P.J. Peterson and won several awards that year at the Caribbean Music Awards and the Canadian Music Awards. In 1998, Buju met the punk band Rancid and recorded three tracks with them, No More Misty Days, Hooligans and Life Won't Wait. The latter became the title track of Rancid's 1998 album Life Won't Wait. Banton performed at the Cricket World Cup 2007 opening ceremony with Third World and Veres Hammond. The album Rasta God Soul was released on 21st April 2009, a date which marked with the 43rd anniversary of Emperor Haile Selassie's visit of Jamaica in 1966. Upon his release from prison in the United States in December 2018, Banton performed his first concert at National Stadium in Kingston, Jamaica on 16 March 2019.